I am a indie developer, mostly working in Unity right now. And I got into game development in college. I went to school at Utah Valley University for a degree of animation and game development. So I really fell in love like immediately when I started doing Unity stuff. And then at some point we had like a side class that was just about Houdini, and then like immediately fell in love with Houdini. So I've just been working with it like for the past 4 years, 5 years at this point.
I am based in Montreal, and I am a teaching assistant at the Lost Boys School of VFX. I started with game development actually at the same time as Colin. We were part of the same program at Utah Valley University, animation and game development, and I too took that same class in Houdini.
Hello, I'm Audrey, and I got into game development at AIE, the Academy of Interactive Entertainment in Seattle, and that's where I learned about Houdini, and that's where I started specializing in visual effects. We started out with like just what the general concept would be, so we were thinking, oh, a food fighting game, like, I don't know, like Street Fighter, but food sort of thing. And then we started thinking about what would be easiest to do in a week-long game jam, and we were talking about, well, maybe something with some physics-based element. And then we just started like talking about really tall burgers somehow, and how it'd be funny if somehow there was some really tall wobbly burger. I know, I'm like wobbling as I say it. And that's kind of where we got on the Sir Stackems idea.
You play as a burger, and you roam around the world and fight other sandwiches and try to steal their toppings until eventually you reach the end and fight the boss.
From the start, we wanted to integrate Houdini into our workflow for our game. We decided on a few ways that might work best for it. In this case, we found it worked pretty well for just the level design. So we blocked out most of the level inside of Unity with ProBuilder, and then we retook those the base layout and basically put it in Houdini to build the terrain and everything. A lot of environment was done with Houdini.
So we used it to create a few custom tools in order to draw small land masses. We also used it for small assets such as the corndog trees, the fries, the lollipop trees, all of which were assets that were fairly repetitive but needed, you know, some amount of variability.
For Houdini and Unity, we used a combination of Houdini Engine with HDAs and a little bit of Session Sync just to get some placement and testing stuff done. A lot of the terrain, like, it was built out in ProBuilder, but then we used some Houdini Engine to draw curves to basically place terrain, and then other curves to place like the trees and the grass, all these other little details. I also created an HDA for Unity Engine for that just automatically creates the hitboxes with the UVs laid out for the shader and the collision box for the actual hitbox.
When you're working on such a tight deadline, it can become difficult to work around people's schedules. There are a lot of tasks that need to be done in a short amount of time. And some of those tasks are dependent on other tasks being done first. And so just working around people's schedules and figuring out, you know, both what they want to do in the jam, as well as what they're capable, given, you know, their individual schedules, is really helpful to actually, you know, finishing a functional game that looks okay.
Just communicate, make a game doc. Just because it's a short project doesn't mean that it doesn't need a game doc. I think communication is honestly that's the most important thing, so that everyone knows how the game works. Make sure everyone agrees with the kind of game you're making.
My advice would be scope. Keep it small, keep it simple. Try not to add like a bunch of features. Try and just like have one basic concept, get that working, and then with whatever time you have left, you can polish it and add on to it. But, you know, if you want to have something finished, you know, have something simple. And also talk to the people on your team about what they want to get out of the jam. Like, one of the first things we did was just talk like what each of us wanted to do, and we decided to sort of build a game around something that could be focused around everything we wanted to do. So instead of also just having a game, we can also learn something and get something else out of just the whole process of making it.